ticket.
I have seen the type of democracy that is not here in Uganda. Maybe it's because the chairperson and the Electoral Commission in general is not appointed by the president, like it is here in Uganda, where the president basically can easily terminate you or chase you away anyhow. There has been independence of the Electoral Commission, and that's the reason that the chairperson of the Electoral Commission came out with strength and was able to announce the winner of the elections. So we desire for that. We desire to see that kind of independence in Uganda.
During this term of His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta, we had some challenges in trade, more especially in agro-based. If you look at poultry, if you look at maize at the border, had a lot of challenges because Kenya at one time stopped our maize to be exported to their country because of aflatoxin. This, as we continue to improve our agro-based, we are also looking forward to see the Kenyan side to continue having better relationship and cooperation on our side so that we can exchange and move freely and export and also import goods from Kenya and either way smoothly in the country to strengthen the East African community ties.
I just appeal to our neighbors to remain calm, to remain peaceful, because whatever affects Kenya, it affects Uganda in one way or another. Most of the goods go through Kenya, come from Kenya, so any violence or any chaos in Kenya impacts on our economy as well. So wish them well, and also congratulate His Excellency Raila Odinga. He has tried his best, but that's the fate, that's the verdict, and I think he should accept that he has tried his best.
At Ruto, he exhibited a very good manifesto. He had his polling station agents in place. He made sure that all his voters register in time. He made sure that the vote is about the people and not the presidency. Even when Uhuru supported Raila, he did not mind. He remained on his message and kept moving with a very good message that was talking about everything: education, health, agriculture, the youth, technology, everything.
We have learned a lot as Ugandans. First of all, this process has been going on starting from the campaigns. And like what we experienced in 2020 and 2021, Kenya has been fairly peaceful. I have not heard of any explosive situations where people were massively arrested or molested during the campaigns. I didn't hear it. Or maybe you people who are active on social media might have read or seen a lot of it, but I did not. And that is a good sign that actually we can have a peaceful election.